is Akanksha Deo Sharma, and I work as a designer for IKEA, and I also have my own practice as a visual artist. And currently, I have just made a big transition for myself. I've moved from India to Sweden, from my home city, Delhi, to the third largest city in Sweden called Malmo. And I could just give you a little bit of the scale. Like, Delhi is about 30 million people, and Malmo is just about 300,000. So it's quite a big change. And while I was preparing for this presentation, I was, asking myself, what does design mean to me? And what does design mean to you guys? And to be able to answer that for myself, I had to go back into my journey, which is, having studied commerce in Delhi University and then followed by fashion designing at National Institute of Fashion Technology in Delhi, I experimented, played, and learned a lot. I think that was my time of exploring a lot of crafts that we have in India, the beautiful history and the heritage. I got the honor of working with a lot of craftsmen all over India from different parts, like Barmer, Bikaner, and Kutch. And now when I think about it, I feel that design is right now, as we stand in this at this time, design is one of the most important and powerful tools to shape behavior, and to shape behavior of people and prepare us for the future, for the ever-changing future. You know, it I think it helps us adapt to the newer times. And then, of course, I thought, how could I give you a little bit gist of the work that I've done that also shows what are the objectives and the purpose for each project. So, so I would like to present to you four of my projects, starting with the first one, which is called Forandring. And it's launched in 2020, and it was also the winner for El Decor India Design Awards. And the main message of this collection has been that we have tried to use the rice straws. The rice straw is like a rice harvest residue that is traditionally burnt in the northern parts of India, which also significantly contributes to air pollution. And coming from Delhi, I can really relate to this problem on a very intimate level. So when the IKEA team came to me and another designer from Finland about this project, I was more than happy. I was just like very passionate to work on this project because it connected with me very closely. And as you can see, it's a combination of like lampshades, bowls, baskets, a lot of textile, rugs, storage, and some other paper products. And here we wanted to keep the material at the forefront. Like, we wanted the material, which is the rice straw, to shine. And the reason for that is that it is traditionally looked as something waste, like as a part of waste. And we want to show people how we could possibly look at waste as resource. And our intention with this project is to turn rice straw into a new renewable resource for our IKEA products. So if you go on to the next slide, I could say that, you know, this project is part of a larger initiative called Better Air Now. And that initiative has been run by our team at IKEA in collaboration with policymakers, with NGOs, with the government. And so it has started on a very ground level, but the collection is just the tip of the initiative, where we are able to show by the means of good design that, you know, we can look at everything around us as a means of resource. We don't have to always use new materials, virgin materials. And I mean, I could say that this project has been a lot about exploration, diving into the unknown, having a lot of trial and errors. We've used a lot of techniques in this collection. So it could, like, quickly saying that it has been a mix of rice straw molding and then making paper out of rice straw pulp and then making cords out of it. And then, of course, taking rice straws just how it is in its truest form as a rice straw husk and weaving it with cotton, you know, in terms of like textile products. And fortunately, yeah, this collection has been received really well all over the world. And it was also nominated for the Beasley Design of the Year for 2020. And currently it's being exhibited in the Design Museum in London till March, I think March 2020. So if anybody happens to be there, they can actually grab a look of the collection. And then moving on to the next collection, which is a really special one for me again. It's actually these two cushion covers that you see in the image. It's called Clara Fina and Moa Kaisa, and it's also launched in 2020. And why it's special is because it has been made by these wonderful women in Bikaner in India. And if you can go to the next slide, you can see a little bit of, you know, how we have worked together. And I could say for this collection, you know, the purpose was to help and empower these women. And the main objective for this project was to create something that helps and empowers these women and gives them a decent means of livelihood, makes them financially independent, and gives them something to look forward to, you know, creatively. So for the previous collection, the material was of this project. And I think I have worked really intimately with these women because in this project, at the end of the day, you know, you have to understand the capacities and the capabilities of these women. Like, what do they like to design? What do they like to make? Or what do they like? What do they not like? So you have to really understand where you design or mold your design accordingly. So it's not really so much about what you feel as an individual, as a designer, but it's more how can you, through your designs, create a positive impact which gives opportunities to other people and also brings them closer. So here the design was really simple. We wanted to create very simple design that is easy to understand for these women and easy to do, and that they enjoy doing this for like a long period of time, which is a period of 1 year. And so, I mean, this has been like a really fruitful collaboration between us at IKEA and these women, because it has been a lot about give and take. The amount that we shared with them, the amount of knowledge we shared with them, equally the same amount of knowledge came back to us, like, because these women also know so much about embroidery and different kind of handcraft techniques. So yes, and then if we go to the next project, this has been also a really interesting and fun project for me. It's an art installation called Interdependence, and it was made in 2019 in collaboration with the Copenhagen-based design and research institute called SpaceTEM, and they had come to India to you know, have a satellite studio in Delhi in Dhanmil compound, and they had like this massive space where they wanted an artist to create like an art installation. And then they approached me, and I think I found the project to be really interesting, because if you go on to the next slide, then you could see the process a little bit as well, because I mean, these are, as you can see, there are like six textile panels that I have designed, and the project combines traditional Indian craft technique with a very circular design mindset to physically reflect and manifest the core goal in Delhi for them, which was to learn from India. And I think Space10, IKEA, and me, we all share like the same values and principles. So it was very important for me to communicate and reflect those same values through this installation. And for this, I in fact collaborated with a really special design studio based in Delhi called 1111 by Cell Design. They work a lot with Indian handcraft, you know, textiles. They work a lot with bandhani, a lot of block printing, a lot of tying and dyeing. So I know that, you know, they have a lot of these, what they term as reclaimed pieces of fabric, which are leftovers. And they make a lot of other products with it within their studio. And so I thought, like, you know, why not just take these reclaimed pieces of fabric and kind of, you know, patch them together and make somewhat like a collage out of it, and give it a new narrative, like give these pieces of fabric a new story. So these six textile panels hang on the ceiling, and you see a different image, a different expression, a different angle, and a play of shadow and light from wherever you stand in like this huge, gigantic space. And the main, you could say, the expression I wanted to create was like this very warm, fuzzy feeling, because it was such a big, expansive space. I wanted to create something that was very welcoming for a lot of people, and something that inculcates the quality of learning and like inquisitiveness and to be curious, because this was a space where Space10 was going to hold a lot of events and a lot of collaboration and a lot of discussion and dialogue. So I wanted this installation to fuel that, to kind of, yeah, instigate that same effect. So I had a lot of fun doing this one, actually. And if we go to the next, one of my last projects for this presentation. So this has been like one of my last project, like art projects, you could say, that was done in 2020. And it was done in collaboration with Smile Foundation and Art and Found, the art agency. They connected with me and they approached me to ask if I would be interested in creating an artwork, an art piece that would then go online for sale. And whatever proceeds would come out of that sale would go into Smile Foundation, into helping like the farmers and the essential workers during the COVID times. So if you go on to the next slide, you could maybe grasp a little bit more images and some close-ups. And for this, you know, this is embroidery. It's hand embroidery on cotton twill. And it's very 3D when you go close to it. But from far, it can look something that's very graphic and flat almost. And that is the fun part of it, because it is actually supposed to represent grains of rice. Why you would ask, and it's like, you know, I was thinking like, what should this artwork be? And as I was sitting and thinking and deciphering this uncertain time that it looked like for the last year, for the most part of last year, one striking conclusion we all realize, I think, is that how vulnerable our international system is, and how it's all interdependent and intertwined. So through this piece, I wanted to play with the idea of domino effect, how one thing affects the other, sort of like the butterfly effect that, we could feel that any problem or struggle in one field was affecting us regardless, eventually. And it also is like a piece that kind of inquires about the roles that we play in the society and how we help each other out. So, the grains of rice is part of the embroidery, and it is kind of like a mark for the countless lives touched and supported by our farmers and other essential workers during these critical times. And it's also to kind of, you know, strike a conversation about questioning our existing systems in order to build regenerative, sustainable, and resilient food systems to further improve agricultural sustainability and to help supply chains withstand problems like this that we've never faced before. So this was part of my last project for this presentation. And I could say that, you know, for each project, there has been a very definitive purpose and a very definitive objective. What are we solving here? Sometimes it's people at the forefront. Sometimes it's the planet at the forefront. And sometimes it's, material or the product or the story, collective story. So it's more like to question as a young designer as well, like, why are you doing what you're doing? What objective are you serving? And how for me, I always try to think like, what we design should make the world a little better place to live in for everyone. And I think that could be like a starting point for some young designers if they're starting out. And just in the end, I would like to quote this amazing woman called Paola Antonelli. She is an author, Italian author, editor, and architect. And currently, she's the senior curator of the Department of Architecture and Design at the Museum of Modern Art, New York. And she said something that's really hits, bang on the point, which is, designers stand between revolutions and everyday life. They're able to grasp momentous changes in technology, science, and society, and convert those changes into objects and ideas that people then can understand. So I feel as designers, we can simplify things for the rest of the world.